and you're tuned in to Ref Plus, your ultimate guide to choosing your next ride and so much more. For today's episode, we're here to talk about cars and the latest about it at this year's Manila International Auto Show. Come follow me, let's take a look. The Manila International Auto Show. Some call it the Mecca of the Philippine automotive world. This is where automotive manufacturers from all over the world converge to unveil their latest lineup, showcasing cutting-edge technology and design. For almost 20 years, this motoring event has become the melting pot for car culture and everything that's going on in the world of cars here in the Philippines. Mr. Jason Ang from the Manila International Auto Show 2024 organizers. Sir Jason, thank you very much for having us and congratulations on 19 years of success for MIAS. But for those unfamiliar though, of course, we might have viewers who are car people but not really familiar with the car scene here. And it's been going on for 19 years, Sir Jason. You know, how's the 19 years been, first of all?
It's been a great ride for us. So we started off here in 2005 in the World Trade Center. And thankfully, with the support of the car industry, MIAS has been growing steadily throughout the years.
Usually when you hear the name Manila International Auto Show, you're familiar with the idea that it happens in one venue. That's the World Trade Center. For years, WTC has become some sort of a home court for MIAS and everybody's familiar with it. But this year, it's not just happening in one venue. It's actually happening in two places. You chose two venues. Why SMX? And what's in SMX that's not here?
SMX has more of our car brands. So those who prefer to exhibit in that venue, we chose SMX because like World Trade, it's a world-class exhibition venue. And what we foresee is that for ease of parking, SMX is the place to go to. What visitors can do is start their visit at SMX, park their car there, and we have free shuttles running throughout the day. So one ticket can access both venues on the same day.
Yes, you heard that right, RevFab. MIAS 2024 has become a two-venue kind of event because of so many cars on display and so many cars also waiting to be revealed. And I know every year the theme always changes. This year it's more about bridging the future. Tell us a little bit about that.
Bridging the future, we chose that theme because this year we want to bring together two venues for the first time, World Trade Center and SMX. And also we want to bridge together the traditional technology of automotive, which is combustion engine, with what they call the new energy vehicles, which are the hybrids and electric vehicles.
So, of course, in the 19 years MIAS has been around, how has MIAS been connected to the ABS-CBN Foundation?
Actually, since the start, we've been supporting the ABS-CBN Foundation's program because we believe in the advocacies and the programs that they like do every year. And I think in our own little way, we're able to support the communities that they're also reaching out and supporting.
But could you tell us a little bit, what are the kind of causes that you guys are supporting primarily?
For this one would be the Bantay Kalikasan, especially when they launched the battery drive and I think the used oil. So I think we encourage all our stakeholders to also take part on it. And I think most of them are also very supportive. Because I think MIAS is also a platform where we provide each companies the area to showcase their new brands, their new products, and at the same time, the advocacy that they also have.
That's right. And you know, it's really nice that, to be able to have one event that really supports and is an avenue, for you to be able to show how you support these advocacies.
Right.
Moving forward, though, of course, MIAS, there's so many years ahead, but any more advocacies you guys want to be tackling towards in the future?
Eventually, of course, into something like some sustainable projects, something that could help the environment because, as mentioned, Auto Show, the automotive industry is another platform wherein, as mentioned by our guest speaker, it indicates growth At the same time, in spite of that growth, you have to take care of the environment. So that's where sustainability comes in, which I think also venturing into the EVs, which we have in the show, is another one step closer to what we wanted.
Gotcha. With the success of Mias right now, 19 years, that's no feat. You know, it's been amazing. And what's Mias planning for the future?
We hope to expand to our space further. We'll see what other spaces we can access for next year. But right now, we just want all the brands to have a good showing and for visitors to have a good time here.
The Philippines has been known internationally as the second fastest growing car market in the ASEAN region, as our market has such a growing demand for all sorts of cars for all needs and preferences. And Mias 2024 plans to bridge the gap into the future with so many cars coming from so many places.